Dear Walter, I am resigning from my job because of how you are acting around the office. I understand that you want to get things done, but I don't think that this is the environment that I want to work in. Just so you know, you're not going to see me again. I hope that you are successful in the future, but I am off for the better. You will receive an email tomorrow containing my resignation form in a PDF document. From Robert.
Hey Dan, you want to come over and play some video games? I don't know, I want to go back to my childhood sometimes. Why not? Alright, bye. Machines aren't even made by the company who owns them. My company didn't make the vending machines, and they would steal your money. It was the worst experience. I'm never going there again.
Why would you go back there? That place sounds like crap.
Yeah. How have you been doing?
Oh, my job as a writer has been doing really good. I just sent my draft for a novel to my editor.
Oh, that's cool, man. So, what's it about?
Okay, so the story is about this guy named Nathan, and he gets lots of money because he's a doctor. And one day, he's in England, and he looks up at the stars, and he realizes that he's a very important person. Then he goes to Israel, and he gets attacked by terrorists as soon as he gets off the airport. And then he realizes that he can never get back to America, and he might die.
Wow, that sounds really cool. You gotta send that to me.
It's just a revised draft, so I'm gonna be making lots of changes to it.
Still, dude, you gotta give me a copy of it. It's so cool!
Thanks, dude. I should show you the website where I got my ideas.
Okay, what is it?
It's this urban legend website. It has really cool stories in it.
Oh, seriously? Urban legends? This stuff has been proved wrong for years now. No one can actually believe that crap.
Let me use your computer for a second, and I can show you one that was posted 2 days ago.
Alright, whatever. Let's go.
Man, this story is so cool, though it leaves you hanging.
And it's what all the stories do.
Yeah, I know, but that's what makes them so spine-chilling.
Whatever.
Look, here it is. It's called Night Ranger. And no, it's not about the 80s band. Okay, so here how's it goes. A few guys went camping in the woods in Maine, not too far from here. They brought with them a few BB guns for target shooting, and a big cooler with food in it, and all kinds of stuff. They set up camp a few miles out in the deep forest, cooked dinner, and had some fun playing around. Then they went to sleep. Then, in the middle of the night, they woke up after they heard this high-pitched scream in the forest. So one of the guys said he'll check it out, and it was probably just an animal. The other two guys thought the exact opposite and thought it could be a person, probably putting a plank or something like that. The guy took the BB gun and went outside. The other two guys sat in the tent and went back to sleep, until there was a scream of horror and a loud ripping of flesh noise was heard. The guys woke up in the tent and dared to step out, so they sat mortified in their tent for the whole night and got maybe 4 hours of sleep. When they woke up in the morning, they searched around the forest and couldn't find their friend, only found a massive blood stain on the ground. So was the story cool?
It sounds so corny and stupid. Why? Just why?
It's a very interesting story.
No, it's not. I have read children's books that are more believable than that.
Oh, really? Name three. At least name one.
Well, Cat in the Hat?
That story is not believable.
Unless you're a child.
Any kid would know the Cat in the Hat isn't real.
So that means any adult would know that this story is not real.
It is real!
Then you're a kid.
Wait, Robert, this story's so cool, it leaves you hanging.
They all do that.
So, I've been meaning to ask you, how was your date with Ashley a few nights ago?
Oh, pretty good.
Oh, great. So, what's she like?
Well, she really enjoys out. She really enjoys going outside. She really likes people who are high-spirited and talkative.
No, what's she like?
What do you mean, Dan?
Like, what's she like physically?
Oh, well, blonde hair, brown eyes, tan skin, she's pretty.
I want details.
Why are you interested in my girlfriend?
I don't know, maybe my curiosity took a hold of me or something.
Why?
I don't know.
I just think that's kind of strange.
Hey, come on, I'm single. I want to know what women are like.
You have met women before, I know it.
Yeah, a girl and I had coffee once, so what?
That's something, isn't it?
No, not really. It's coffee.
What'd you talk about?
Traffic.
Traffic? Seriously? Traffic?
The traffic here is ridiculous. People drive like shenanigans.
Yeah, says the guy who almost swerved off the frickin' road.
That was an accident. Something got the sun in my eye.
What made the sun get in your eye? You had sunglasses on that day.
Those sunglasses were flimsy. The frames were dark enough.
So you're going to be driving around with black frames, not knowing where you're going? Really smart, Dan. Really smart.
But black frames are perfect.
Alright, let's change the subject.
We could talk about traffic.
Yeah, but that subject's old. We could talk about, Oh, got it! Gas prices.
Gas prices? That's an awesome subject.
Have you seen how gas prices have lowered?
Yeah, they've been above $3 for like the past 10 years. Now they're in the 170s.
Amazing, huh?
Well, I guess I'll see you later.
Alright.
Bye.
Bye. Hey, Frederick, what's up? Dan, you don't have to do this!
Be quiet, Robert.
Dan, what are you doing?
So I think that's what Payne was doing.
Really? Are you sure that's what Payne wants? Does he control people like that?
Robert, I heard his voice in my freaking head. I know what he's doing. What do you know about Payne that is unusual? Not himself.
Well, I have heard him talking to himself. Do you think that Payne is holding secrets?
Yes, I do, Robert. Tomorrow afternoon, we'll find out what this crackpot is up to.
your friend Dan?
Yeah.
Come on in.
So, Payne, I wanted to ask you several questions.
Ask away.
So, how's everything going on around here?
Oh, fine.
Oh, really?
Using the gun I gave you won't solve anything.
What are you talking about?
The gun is a blank robber. Haven't you heard of them? It's too late for Robert and Dan. It's coming.
What is it?
Oh, you don't know? Haven't you known this whole time?
I've had enough of this crap. Tell me everything you know!
You can't know yet, Dan! We get back to my house. Now!
Okay, let's go!
Let's go.
I feel like that escape was way too easy. Something else has gotta happen. What did he mean by it's coming? I honestly have no idea.
I don't know, but we need to prepare if anything else happens.
Hold on, my cell phone ring.
Control and it and how it's crossed into my area somehow. I don't know what he's talking about.
Wait a minute, it all makes sense now.
What makes sense?
The story, Robert, the story.
What story? What are you talking about?
The urban legend that I showed you, it said three guys went up in Maine and got attacked, and now it's crossing to our area.
Dude, we are far away from Maine. I don't think that official monster is going to attack us. Besides, the story isn't scary anyway. It really is not.
Payne is using the monster, Robert. He's using the Night Ranger in very bad ways.
This story is fake. All of them are fake. Okay, let's just stay here tonight, alright? I'm not afraid of Payne whatsoever.
It's kind of cold here. Can you up the thermostat?
Sure.
Thank you. Sister Christian, oh, the time has come. And you know that you're the only one to say, okay. Where you go and what you looking for? You know those boys don't wanna play no more with you. It's true.
Who's it?